Standing for the invocation.
Scripture I'm going to read is Hebrews 12, verses 1 and 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin that clings so closely. And let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, who, for the sake of the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we praise you this afternoon. We thank you for all of those who have come before us, who have praised you and worshiped you in this place, the servants, and we thank you for them. And we also thank you for all that you have planned for this church going forward in the future. And we thank you for the power that you have to bring all of those things to come. And we bring all these things in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you, JC. We invite you to be seated today. We are so happy to welcome you here for this 100-plus anniversary celebration of Eau Claire Baptist Church. A little bit later, we'll have a recognition of special guests, as well as past staff members, former pastors, and also the anniversary committee that has pulled together and worked so very hard to make this day possible. But right now, we just want you to know how happy we are that you've taken time out of your Sunday afternoon to be here, to worship the Lord with us, to celebrate his goodness together. How many of you know today that God is a good God? Amen? Amen. God has been so good to this congregation, to those of you that have been a part of this congregation in recent years, in past years, in current years. God has been so good to bless the life and ministry of Eau Claire Baptist Church. And we just want to take a moment to welcome you and thank God for the part you have had in the history and in the present ministry of this congregation. So please feel very welcomed today. You'll notice there are a couple of things inside your bulletin that we want you to just take note of. One of those is a map of the church building here, which I'm assuming all of you or most of you are familiar with. So please take the opportunity after the service today to fellowship, to stay together, to mingle the grounds. We'll have some cake and punch serving stations, a few different places that are noted on the map. Please spend the afternoon here with us, and let's fellowship together and just enjoy the goodness of God as we celebrate His blessings. So welcome to you. We're so glad you're here, and we want to just take a few moments to turn the program now over to some who are no stranger to Eau Claire. I ask you to turn your attention to this side for our puppets today.
Run for your life.
Why?
You'll never guess what just happened.
I give up. What happened?
Never in a million years. You won't
Skip! I give up. Tell me.
You don't have to yell, Herb. I'll tell ya.
So tell me.
You remember what Farmer Taylor said would happen if he caught us playing ball on his land again?
Do I ever? He said he'd boil us in peanut butter.
Yeah, well, I just saw him come out of his house and head this way with a family-sized jar of Skippy.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. We better get off his land.
Does it hurt?
What?
Being boiled in peanut butter.
I don't know, but I don't want to find out.
Me neither.
We kind of deserve to be, though.
Yeah, but I'd rather not.
Hey, maybe if we tell him we're sorry, he'll forgive us. Maybe he'll have mercy on us.
Hey, that's just like what Mr. Quimper said today.
Huh?
He was talking about God's mercy or grace. This is just like it.
You mean where the Bible says that it's because of God's grace that we're saved?
That's right. Even though we don't deserve it, God had mercy on us and made a way for us to go to heaven.
Well, I'm sure thankful for God's grace. I hope Farmer Taylor has some.
Hey, look. He's waving at us. Maybe we should go apologize.
Yeah, I guess so. Let's go, Herb.
Okay, but you go first.
Well, no, why don't you go? Because you can talk. No.
Oh, my name is Ticklish Reuben from way down in Old Vermont. I've been tickled by almost everything. I've been tickled by a feather. I've been tickled by a wasp. I've been tickled by a yellow bumblebee.
That's all, folks.
Well, hey, let's give these puppets a hand today. We're so grateful for all of you that are here with us. We want to take a moment just to recognize any special guests that are with us. You know, ministry could not happen with those that come alongside and encourage, support, pray for the work of the ministry that God has given to us here at Eau Claire. And so I know we sent out invitations to a lot of folks. So we did send out invitations to city and community leaders, as well as some of our denominational leaders and ministry partners that have come alongside of us to help. So we are grateful for all of the partners in ministry along the way, as well as neighbors and those within the community that we counted a great joy to serve alongside of. So we'll just take just a moment for any of our neighboring churches or neighboring church leaders, anyone from the seminary, or any of our denominational partners in ministry, we would like to just ask you to stand if that includes you. All right, I'm so grateful, Elizabeth. Thank you, Elizabeth Nance Coker from the Cooperative Baptist Fellowship of South Carolina. So glad for you to be with us today. And we thank God for you, for your ministry, and for the other partners of ministry that we labor together with for the cause of Christ. So we're so glad that God has brought you alongside of us in this way. So thank you for that. I also want to take a moment to recognize the anniversary committee. They have spent countless hours getting ready for today. They have been working very diligently. Originally, this celebration, as you may know, was planned during the 100th year of ministry, which would have fallen right in the middle of COVID. And as you can imagine, that did cause some interruption. But thank God, we are still here today to celebrate. And so I just want to call the names of each committee member. And to this committee, I want to say to you as your pastor, how grateful I am for the work that you have done, for the diligence that you have poured into this day to make this possible. You will hear from some of these folks later, but let me just call the names of the full committee, and then I'll ask them all to stand in unison. Richard and Carolyn Moore. Richard chaired this committee. Eric and Edna Moore. Amanda and Sandra Porter, Henry and Janie Yelton, Julia Paris and Sandy Pristino. If you all would please stand for just a quick moment. And if we could give them a hand of thanks today. Also Terry Finch, all right. Terry Finch as well. So thank you to this committee for all of your hard work. This day would not have been possible without you. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to Joe, and he may say a word of introduction for our special music guest today. So, Joe, I'll turn it over to you at this time.
Thank you. It is so good to see you this morning and to hear you sing. In fact, let's sing Faith of Our Fathers, just one verse, and let's remain seated this time.
This should be very easy for me because this is my family, who I love very much. So I'm going to try to get through this. So I'm here to talk about the staff. That's one of the things I'm here for. I am a staff member at this time. Oh my gosh, I can see my thumb. So recently, I contacted two staff members from here to solve a mystery that I had. Since I was in the office and I was thinking about this all the time, I said, oh, I've just got to solve this mystery. It's been 40 years. So I called two staff members, and it took a few calls, but I finally found out my mystery. So if you ask me about it later, I will tell you. I'm not going to tell you because it was a big secret for a long time. So those two people are Reverend Ron Wilson, who is here today. I'm so excited because he comes right after me. And his wife, Janice, who were missionaries and left here, but we were so honored that they're here today. And also, Mary Ann Brunson, who is not here. I heard she's a little ill today, but she helped me so much, and she's a former secretary here that I love very much. And so I just wanted to make sure that I introduced them. And we have another pastor here, Jimmy Gadlock, great friend of mine, I have to say. I call him Jimmy, so. But anyway, Jimmy served here a long time. And I have to say, one of the things about Jimmy is he helped a lot of folks go to heaven that were here. And that was a wonderful thing. So we had a lot of congregation that left during the time he was here. And so he served us very well here. We still miss him and his wife, Dee, who was a wonderful soloist here. I just wanted to recognize Jimmy, who will be up here later. Let's see where I'm at. So I also wanted to talk about Kelly. Kelly Strum is here. She was a co-pastor at one time with Jimmy, and her husband, Dave, is the bookkeeper here now with me. So that's very helpful because I replaced Ray Moore, who had both those jobs, and we split them up. And so that was a good thing. Dave and Kelly run the Cornea program. And if you can climb the stairs, please go to the third floor. It is a wonderful program. And you will see something that you will not regret seeing up there. I get to be here during the week with the children, and it is a great program. But Kelly was a great minister here to all of us, and we appreciate them very much here. And of course, you know, Stephen Baltknight, who was up here a minute ago, he is my great communicator. That's why I call him. He communicates me very well since he has another job. Also, he got us through COVID. And one time, I just thought I'd share. I don't know if anybody saw this on the Facebook page, but one time I felt sorry for him because he kept coming in here preaching to pews and to a camera. So I put pictures where everybody sat on the pews. I can't find it right now, but it was a great picture. I had pictures of everybody from the pictorials where they sat. So he would at least see faces in here. So I thought that I would share that. But he is wonderful to be here with us, and we appreciate him and his family very much. I'd like to talk about Mr. Ray. Ray was here 18 years, I believe, or more, serving as our ministry assistant. He talked to me for a long time. When are you coming? When are you coming? When are you going to retire? So for 3 years, he talked to me, and I came on. But one day, Ray was in the office, and they didn't have someone to do the bulletin, and he stepped into the position, and he kept it for a long time. We had a great celebration for Ray when he did retire, and I've taken over. And one of the things I noticed when I came in his office is there was like a medicine chest on his desk. I'm like, why? He takes a lot of medicine. I said, oh. And I thought, well, you know, I started cleaning up, and I thought, then I go look in there today. It's like, oh, it looks like Ray's desk now. So I kind of know what he went through with that. To go on to the music, our wonderful music program here, we have Monty and Melanie Hatcher here. Monty put up with me as a teenager and the rest of my friends that are here. And he was here during my teenage years. And Melanie played the organ. She probably played the piano too some, but I know she played the organ. Monty and Melanie brought us a lot of things here that are here today. One is the puppets, because I was in the beginning when the puppets came, and Monty brought us the puppets. Also, Monty and Melanie brought us the handbells. We had handbell choirs back then. I was part of that group. We also have the quartet, which has grown, and people have come and gone, and Monty brought us that, the quartet. We've had a lot of people serve on the quartet, and so we're happy, so happy that they could come and be with us today. Very blessed. So moving on, so Joe Derrick, who is right here, my friend, and Joe has been here a long time. Well, and his family, he's from here. So we love Joe, and we appreciate Joe and Sharon very much. And Joe has gotten us through some lot of good times. And we're happy to have Joe, and we hope he continues to be with us for a long time. Let's see, where am I at? Okay, so Robin Brazil is here. She was our pianist here, and we're happy to have her. Also, Sharice Miller is here. She's on the piano right now. This is my cousin, in case y'all don't know that. She is my second cousin. And and also, Bill Johns is here on the organ. They were here for a long time and played together. We're very blessed that they're here today to play for us. It is wonderful to have them. Okay, let's see. So, I don't want to leave anybody out. So, also, let's see. Now, we have some children here that were, oh, wait a minute. There's my Fred. You know, I can't forget my Fred because Fred's my lifesaver. You know, it's hard for me to talk about Fred because Fred lives next door. He's my friend. Anyway, I won't talk about Fred no more. But anyway, Fred is our organist here. And I didn't want to leave him out. God, did I cover everybody? So, also, I wanted to recognize anybody here that was family members for staff here. I don't want to leave anybody out. I know Karen Metcalf is here. We're really excited because she's Calvin Metcalf's daughter is here. We also received letters from Herb Hash, who I talked to on the phone. And we also received a letter from Wallace Hughes, and they are in the memory room. So when you go down there, please look at those. Herb's wrote a few books that are on Amazon if you want to check them out. And they're doing wonderful, and so glad to have talked to them, but they were not able to come today. So, and the Blues are here. Dot Blues' sons are here, so we're happy to have them. And I don't want to make sure I missed anybody. Now, here's some very important jobs here that were on staff. And so anybody in here that locked up the church, cut the grass, or I have something else on here, or clean the church, can you stand up, please? Because that's important jobs. Look at all these people, you know, come on. Look at Mr. Ray and Eric, you know. We had a lot of people that cleaned this church. And so we want to make sure we don't forget anybody. So everybody I mentioned, would you please stand up and let's give everybody a hand real quick. All right. Okay, Mr. Joe, I think I'm done.
Well, it's such a joy to be here today and celebrate this church. You know, Janice and I were reflecting about this. It was 50 years ago, last month, that we came to serve Eau Claire, straight from Southwestern Baptist Theological Seminary in Fort Worth. And when we came, we didn't have a lot of experience. Thank goodness for Brother Calvin. He helped us through a lot of times there in just learning how to do things. And Eau Claire was certainly a blessing to us. And from here, we stayed here 3 years, and then we went to serve with IMB for 40 years and retired in 2015. And when I think about IMB, I think about the missionaries that have come from this church and continue to come from this church. Have the Moores. Then we had Ann Falal. Then we had Chris and those who are still serving today and others. So how blessed we are just for the training ground and for the experience of this church. So I want you to know that you continue to be a blessing to us. We look at your Facebook page and see all the things that are going on, and that helps us stay up to date. We now live up in Lancaster. And that's where we live. Now, I'd like to read today a passage of Scripture that's found in Ephesians 1:15 through 23. For this reason, I too, having heard of the faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, which exists among you, and your love for all the saints, do not cease giving thanks for you, while making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you a spirit of wisdom and of revelation and the knowledge of him. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened so that you will know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of his glory, of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power towards us who believe. These are in accordance with the working of the strength of his might, which brought about in Christ when he was raised from the dead and seated at the right hand in the heavenly places. Far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things in subjection under his feet, and gave him as head over all things in the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all.
That's some toe-tapping music, isn't it? Thank you so much. What a blessing. In the words of St. Paul in his letter to the Romans, the 12th chapter, we, the church, are urged in view of God's mercy to offer our very selves as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. We are reminded that this is our spiritual act of worship. As I prepare to lead us in our offertory prayer, may I first offer my own personal spiritual act of worship by thanking God for leading me to this church 19 years ago this fall in 2004 as a seminary student next door. Little did I know Pastor Jimmy Goudlot would be my supervisor, who had baptized me in 1986 at Springdale Baptist Church. Where are you, Jimmy? Right there. When I was 11 years old. Wow, what a beautiful thing. And I wish to thank you, Eau Claire Baptist Church, for being the body of Christ to me and my family over these last almost 20 years. You have taught me, you have believed in me, you have loved me, and ordained me. In this sanctuary and within the circle of this fellowship, Dave and I were married. My family and I said goodbye to my dad. Dave and Malachi were baptized, and Cameron will be soon. You stand alongside Dave and me as we dream God's dream of welcome, child of God, through Koinonia of Columbia, as you too have loved and welcomed the children of this neighborhood for so many years. On behalf of the beloved community of Koinonia of Columbia, we have placed a statue of Jesus in the roses outside the church office that the children planted a few years ago to say thank you to their church. The Koinonia floor will also be open for you to tour after our service together. If you are a part of the Koinonia family, you have volunteered, have come here, and the children, the parents, board members, staff members, anyone, if you would please stand so we can thank you. Thank you so much. And Elizabeth, I know we have recognized you, our Cooperative Baptist Fellowship partnership with South Carolina. Elizabeth, thank you so much, along with this church, for believing in Koinonia and being such an advocate for the children and families of this neighborhood. So words are inadequate to thank you, dear church, for the richness of all these memories and milestones for the Strum and Dickerson families. And just think, we're just one family. Imagine with me all the memories and milestones Eau Claire Baptist Church has provided for all of her families over all these 102 years. Truly, we are standing on holy ground. Let us pray. Our most gracious and loving Lord, as we humbly bow our heads and hearts before you, we pause to be aware of your gaze of love that is constantly on us, your children. We look back and we say thank you. We love you, too. We thank you for the seasons of our lives and our church's life. That there is a time to be born and a time to die, that there is a time to mourn and a time to dance. And today we dance. We dance with the great Trinity who invites us into the eternal great dance. We thank you, loving God, that you choose to manifest yourself in so many ways to us, your children, that we can see you in one another, and that together we can become the body of Christ here through your church. And so we pause to be aware of the many who have done this here at Eau Claire Baptist Church, for the great cloud of witnesses by whom and upon whom this church has been built. And we say thank you, God, for all the prayers, sermons, Bible studies, cantatas, vacation Bible schools, mission projects, baptisms, weddings, baby dedications, funerals, and potluck dinners we have offered ourselves to you as living sacrifices. It is our prayer this day that we hold close to heart the words given the early church to continue to be devoted to one another in love. May we rejoice in hope. be patient in affliction, persevere in prayer, contribute to the needs of the saints, pursue hospitality to strangers, and in so doing, at this time of offering, we place much more than money in these plates. We offer ourselves as a spiritual act of worship as we continue to be the hands, the feet, the heart, the body of Christ here in Eau Claire. In the name of Jesus, our Christ and our Lord and our Savior, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
please.
Good afternoon. My name is Sandra Leaphart Pristino, and I became a part of this church 81 years ago. It has been a wonderful journey to be a part of this church. So part of my job in this committee was to be putting together the history. And Julia and I worked on it together. That's what happens when you get old. We are presenting the history in several different ways. You're going to see a PowerPoint presentation. You're going to see slideshows throughout your tour as you go from room to room. We've got slideshows that you can sit and watch and gawk at people that you knew a long time ago and maybe at yourself. And we also have a history book that has been put together. Now, the history book costs lots of money, so you only get one per family. So don't go taking the five or six of them, because we'll go back and charge you for them if you're not careful. We hope you have a wonderful time with us and you enjoy our history, because you've been a part of it. Thank you for coming.
That was quite a memory. Well, I bring you greetings from the Metcalf family, from Gary, Tina, and I, and my mom. And also, I'm so glad to have my aunt and uncle here, Myron and James Hall, that are with us today. So thank you for this opportunity. Churches are like home, and this one was literally like a home to me because it became my playground since we live next door. It is always a joy and an honor to be back here, and thank you for asking me today. Let us join together in the responsive reading. You'll find it in your bulletin, or it's number 692 in the hymnal. I will read the light if you will follow in the dark. Print. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might.
And these words which I command you this day shall be upon your heart.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The entrance of thy words giveth light. It giveth understanding to the simple.
The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure,
making the wise simple. My son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight.
With my whole heart have I sought thee. Oh, let me not wander from thy commandments.
Thy word
have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin.
If you've been blessed today, would you say amen?
Amen.
Thank you to all of those that have led us. I want to just leave you with a couple of quick words today before we leave this place. Before that, I do want to remind you downstairs, there is a quilt that has been placed there for your signature. We want to remember and celebrate your part of the story and involvement with Eau Claire, so please be sure to go downstairs and sign the quilt. Also, as Kelly mentioned, we want to make sure those of you that are able, please do make your way up to the third floor in the building next door so that you can observe and see the ministry that is happening today through Koinonia of Columbia, through this church, and within this community. And please stay with us, fellowship together, enjoy cake, enjoy punch, and spend some of the rest of your afternoon with us today. Before we leave, I just want to share with you three thoughts about Eau Claire. And the first is this, is that God has blessed his people at Eau Claire with a great past. We have celebrated that today. The slideshow was tremendous to remind us of so many ways that we have seen God work and move. From the responsive reading that was just read, Psalm 119, verse 105 reminds us that the word of the Lord is indeed a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. And so all of the ways that God has allowed his word to light and guide the way of so many that have come through the doors of this fellowship, we thank God for that. God is up to something good here. Amen?
Amen?
I mean, if you're a native of Columbia, any place that has been in business for 57 years, longer than Lizard's Thicket, it's got to be a good thing. Amen? God has blessed his people with a great past. Second, I want you to know today that God is blessing us with a great present. The scripture reading that Ron read for us from Ephesians chapter 1, verse 19 reminds us, I pray you will continually experience the immeasurable greatness of God's power. And God is indeed blessing our fellowship today with a great present as we experience His immeasurable power. All of the things that happen, the ministries that happen in and through this place, Wednesday nights, Koinonia after school and summer program, so many of the ministries that you saw pictured in the slideshow, God is blessing us with a great present. And third and last today, I want you to know as we leave this place that God will bless Eau Claire with a great future. Do you believe that? Say amen. Amen. God will bless us with a great future. In the responsive reading, the words were read from Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding, and in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. We will trust the Lord with all of our heart, and we will lean on into His understanding for His will for our lives. And we as a church will fulfill the work God has for us to do. What an exciting day and time it is to be a part of this great fellowship. And we're so glad that you've come together to celebrate with us today. I want to ask Jimmy Goudlock to make his way up to lead us in a benediction. And after the benediction, you'll be dismissed. Please stay with us toward the grounds. Please sign the quilt downstairs. And it's been so great to have you here for this celebration today. Jimmy?
A lot of memories were created here. One of my favorite ones is when I came here 23 years ago, I met one of the leaders of the church, Ray Moore. Ray was a secretary and fill-in pastor in case I didn't get to do what I was supposed to do. He taught me something I've never forgotten. I already had 30 years experience when I came here, but he told me, he said, it's easier to get forgiveness than it is permission. So just go ahead and do it. Anyway, it got me in a lot of trouble, but I managed to make it through it. And then the joy of Kelly Strom, after having baptized her and been a part of her marriage ceremony, and then have her come next door to the seminary and come and I taught her how to visit, how to deal with people in different circumstances and situations, how to work within the church. That's what I taught her the first week. But she was so smart. She thinks circles around me. And finally I decided, I got to watch this girl. So I talked to the staff and people at the church, and they made her co-pastor. That way she wouldn't take my job over altogether. And so that was the way I got through it. But what a joy it's been to know so many of the most wonderful people. I don't know how many times I've told Dolores, the greatest 13 years of my life was right here. And I loved the people here. And I was loved by the people here more than any other place I've ever been. It'll always be a special place in my heart. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and forever. Amen.
You're dismissed. Yeah. Thank you.